Greetings, one and all. And we've got the X Touch knife. X Touch. I'm sure that's not the way to pronounce it. And you know what? I don't care. I actually really could care less. All I care about is funny name, but not so funny knife, right? And we like to mess around in the crazy world of unknowns. Back in the day, some of the unknowns used to be such famous names as Petrified Fish or Ganzo or Tucson or even Artisan Knives and that kind of thing. And now they ain't so like unknown. So we'd be looking at, Beyond EDC is a new brand and Shield and Knives. And so you never know what's coming at you next, do you? So the best defense is a good offense. Go out there in the jungle on Amazon and the Amazon jungle and catch you a knife. So I did. I did. See? I'll put the links to the other X Touch knife videos. I've done a couple of them. A couple of them, okay? So we'll see how this develops over time. Now, I am starting to test knives again. I got a dozen knives out for testing. So we're going to start doing batches again. Batch with the report. Of course, those videos nobody watches, but I find it informative. Other people seem shocked and surprised when they come across my batch videos going, "What? Didn't know." It's like, I don't know. So maybe I'm just not using the right keywords or something when I publish my videos, but I think it's interesting. When they say this is 14C28N, I want to know, is it really 8CR, 5CR? What is it? Okay. And so we're gonna have these tested too. Probably this one because this one's black coated, and that plays hell, I think, with the XRF analyzer. Okay. Doesn't really bother the Rockwell machine, but it whatever. So this one I got, and here's the story. So to be totally bluntly, horribly honest with you, I got this knife from because I had already done a couple knives of their brand, and they noticed that I actually gave a shit or was putting it on my channel. And they contacted me and said, "We got a button lock out. Can we send you one of our budget button locks?" And I go, "Oh yeah, don't send me a $500 knife, okay? Okay, no, no, but okay, $52 banger, right?" And I'll see if I got a discount code or something. And you can always check these Amazon things to see if there's a special discount or something like that. And I don't know. And you can get this, like I'm saying, the in black or green. Okay. Only 10 left. You better get on it, dude. And what do they got? Oh, apply $8 coupon? Oh, okay. You save an additional on this at checkout details. Okay. So I'm just saying, wow. Okay. Now, they sent me this one. And I got out of the box and I was messing with it. I go, "You know what? Ooh, that detent's really, really soft on this thing." Come on. There you go. I mean, I'm not shaking it that hard. Okay. I go, So did I put it on my channel and scream and yell about it? No. I got back with them and said, "Detent's soft on this, you know?" And I said, "I'm not putting it on my channel because I'm not going to say nice things about it if it's this soft. I mean, otherwise, the knife is fine. Is it usable? Does it lock up fine? Okay. Everything except, it shakes out pretty easy." I said, I don't know. And they said, "Oh, okay, well, I'm part of the reason they sent me the knife is so I could check it out and get back to them with my ideas or whatever." So here comes this. So If you'll see this, this is the 602, and this here is the 603. If you see that, okay. It's just because they're different colors, but here's the 602. Now this, you know what I'm saying? Whoops, I feel my shoulder already starting to go. But come on, I know you could do it. Yes, so it is stronger. Is it crazy strong now? No, but it's appropriate, okay? Okay, you know what I'm saying? I felt it start to go. Hold on. Okay. But you gotta, yeah. Now, this is easier. This is always easier, of course. Okay. But no, this now is okay. Okay. But I'm glad that they responded to that. I mean, that's pretty cool. And so this is the 603. And no, this is the 602, right? 602, 603. But now I have both, right? So, hey, baby. And this is po totally usable and carryable, you know? And, you know, I'm just thinking about the guys that, you know, jump off two-story buildings and do a layout pike and land on their feet. And, you know, this knife might open in your pocket. Me, I only do, sometimes I do a 2.5 layout, but that's from a sitting position on the ground. So, oh. But this will stay shut. So, and it is also 14C28. And is it really? No. Well, I don't know. We're gonna find out. We're gonna send it off for testing. Actually, we're gonna send this one off for testing. And this one's gonna have to live with whatever this is. And we'll see if we could get a Rockwell on there. But we got to get a flat spot. And I think that we could hit it there. I don't know if we got to have a quarter inch area, but okay. So these are button locks and they're G10. So now that I've jackjawed forever, deep carry pocket clip. And I like the setup on the pocket clip. This is fine. This is really how I like. I like for it to come up and I like for it to flatten off right here. Okay. It gets the lip of your pocket and it goes in, but this holds on. Okay. And will it go left hand? No, of course not. Why should we let left hand people be happy? And it's a button lock. So this is fidget friendly. And of course, you can middle finger flick it and you can thumb flick it. What do you want to do? You know, I mean, there's a lot of fidget friendliness here, but it seems like it's locked up good. There's liners, you know, that are on here. They're not nested, they're not hidden. So it feels pretty tough structurally. Let's get a little piece of paper and just, oh wow. Okay, let's try this one. That one, yes. Okay. So, I mean, somebody took the time to put an edge on them, that's for sure. You know, and so if they're 14C, and they're, what were they, $56 or something? And then you could kick that for another $8, 53, 8, 45. I mean, you know, you're talking send cut prices. So if you want a send cut, go buy a send cut. I mean, this is just optional stuff. I mean, if you like to kind of just mess around, it doesn't cost you much money. If you're a Prime member, then it's zero shipping. You do have to pay tax, but this might be something that might be of interest to you. They went to the trouble to put a backspacer on it. I like that look. And then that tubes this lanyard hole, which is adequately large, right? And so you have a choice of this kind of OD green black, which is pretty striking. And or if you really prefer just a stone wash, then you can do that. Or get both and swap the scales. You see what I'm saying? So you could have a black, I mean, this would be black, everything would be black on here. Then you could go green with the stone wash. That's not a bad idea. That's not a bad idea, actually. Okay, just thinking to myself. But it seems like they toned the box up too, because now it's got their brand name on here, right? And what do these boxes remind you of? They look like Vanguard series, Kaiser Vanguard series boxes. I mean, they probably got a box manufacturer that makes, shit for everybody, but and yeah, you get a zipper pouch. Okay? And I mean, so it's not just like, cheapy out of the box, nothing. And they give you a microfiber cloth. A zipper pouch looks as good as whatever. And it's plastic in there. So I mean, for 52 bangers and then really end up with about 45 bangers or 46 out the way, then I'm trying to fault it, but I don't find a lot of fault with it. It's just a matter of, do you like this kind of design or not? And really, the ergos here for me, they fit. They fit well. Okay. It's not going to be everybody because you got this. So if you got smaller hands, this might hit you in the middle of the second finger. See what I'm saying? Because fat boy here, he's okay. And then the rest of the guys are hanging off. But it could hit you, if you got smaller. Yeah. Right there. But no, I'm good, and I don't really feel the pocket clip much. I guess you would in extended cutting chores and stuff, but it seems like there's good purchase on here, and it's not so thin that it's unstable in my hand. It's thick enough, it's tall enough, the handle is, and button action, I'm not getting button stick. It seems to be pretty easy to function with. It's centered, it's solid. We will take it apart and take a better look at it. Let's look at the design flow, and here it's going right into the bolster. Let's blade the handle length. Well, you've got this backspacer and you got that. I mean, that's plenty. I mean, you're there, right? And how much does it weigh? And then how big an old boy is it? We'll find that out here right real quick. 4.3 ounces. So it's right in the middle. I mean, it's a kind of a chunky in the hand thing. So it's not super light at 124 grams, right? So pull the tape on it and take a look. Not 3.5. But it's not 3.25 either. It's a 3.3. It's kind of like that mid-size Kaiser sheepdog, right in there. And then overall, not 7 inches, right? Not a 3 and a 7, is it? Because it's closer to 8. It's close to 7/8. It's 7.8. Yeah, about 7.8 inches. And you've got close to 20 centimeters. I mean, 19.8 centimeters. Okay. Now, how fat? That's kind of the key here because it does feel like a handful. 13.4 at 0.53. So, I mean, if it was, here's your Spyderco. Yeah, that's your PM2 about right there. Okay. Nope. It's got to come out. So it's thicker in the hand than that. And it's heavier than that, too. The paramilitary 2 is 3.8 ounces. And blade. Well, 0.1. So what? 3 millimeter? 2.6. 2.6. Okay. It's slicing through the paper, doing a pretty good job. Ambidextrous thumb studs and jimping up here. Not really a go forward position here, but there's a little, just a little kind of area in here where when you sharpen or strop, it kind of gets out of the way so you can get the blade to the strop or to the stone or whatever and not jack this up too much. So, yeah, I mean they're thinking about it, and then you got skeletonized liners too. I mean, go figure. I mean that there's something, right? And it's a button lock, and for no more than it costs, I think we're in good shape. So let's see if we can screw this thing up. And can we? Well, one thing we're going to do is we're going to unscrew it, right? Because we didn't have the whole pivot turning. I mean, how many knives still? They don't have a captured pivot, both sides turned. You got to jump in on the other side. But at least on this, you do have another side to jump in on, right? So you can do that. Now, these are going to be number sixes. I'll guarantee you. And of course they are. And of course they are. And boy, that one was hanging on for dear life. Let's get you out of there. Come on. Come on. Come on. You don't want to let go, do you? Okay. And we got pocket clip time. Let me see. I wonder if this and that one pocket clip are doing double duty. What do you think? And well, let's pull both these off. I think one may be longer than the other, possibly, if I'm guessing correctly. Okay. Yeah, maybe not. Nope, they're the same size. Okay, pocket clip screws, same size. Here comes the. Okay, so that's where the spring sits down, and they got some grease in there, and I think I'm gonna leave the grease in there. Okay, and there's the spring. Bingity bang. Ah, this is interesting. This is the first time I've seen a spring do this. Look at that. Yeah, and it's greased up too. Baby, these are like wheel bearings. Okay. And remember packing wheel bearings with grease? And can't work on them no more. There's the liner. Okay. So we have a washer on a steel liner. Okay. I mean, do it if you want to do it, I guess. This is interesting too. See this? Okay. So this is built into this right here. That's odd. Maybe that stabilizes the button. You know what I'm saying? And keeps it from having any lateral play there. And then here we're coming out with everything. Woo, I bypassed the button, didn't I? And there's the button. Oh, you know what? And there's a bunch of grease in there, but the button has a little collar on it, doesn't it? So it can't push back through. Okay, no, it cannot push back through. And here's the pivot. Okay, take a look. Interesting. Hold on. Oh, okay. Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. Something's going on here. There is something going on here. I thought I saw. Let me look around the camera. No, I don't see an area where this is captured. So it's not captured, but it just unscrewed anyhow. So, okay. And here's these. Okay, so we've got those are ceramic, yeah, those are ceramic bearings. So ceramic bearings. I think you've gone about as far as you can go when you're doing ceramic bearings. You skeletonize your liners, you got nice grippy G10, you're doing a button lock. You're using 14C, deep carry pocket clip, all those things, and with an $8 coupon, you're getting it around mid $40 range. I think that's, I don't see you doing much better than that, do you? I mean, there's that Facebook group that goes into real, and I can't remember the name of them, but it's like a competition to find the most inexpensive knives and stuff. But this, I mean, for trying to find the best value for the dollar, which I think is really interesting. But yeah, I mean, this would be entered in my competition right there. It's like beat the things that they're doing here for the price. So I say what you want, but I've taken a lot of knives apart, and this looks like 75, 80 bucks, right? I mean, it's pretty much the same. Dank, dank. So Hold on. Quiz. Is that the 602 or the 603? Which one is it? I'm gonna call it 602 and ding ding ding. Yeah, I win. Okay. But this, yeah, wow. Now she's gone out of control. So don't know. I mean, these are the things that we gotta investigate. We're gonna test the steel. But if that's the real deal, Holyfield, then it depends on the next thing, which is, to you, is this a design of a knife that you are attracted to? And are you willing to pay only about $48 for a knife? I mean, I know it's kind of like, oh man, I have an opportunity. I can buy a knife for 300. Why would I pay 46? Okay, but just saying, might be a good little user banger around the house, carry, definitely fidget friendly, and for the dollar, okay, you don't have to holler. So I'll leave you to it. I just thought it was interesting. It looks like they refined the box, microfiber cloth, the zipper pouch, all that kind of stuff. And in case you didn't know, we love them knives. You guys, stay sharp.